Hello friends, in last lecture we discussed about the X-ray diffraction. Now today we will discuss about the X-ray spectra. Now when intensity of the different wavelength of X-ray coming out from any source are plotted with a wavelength, then we get two type of spectras. Means if we plot the intensity of different wavelength of X-rays which is coming from any source versus the wavelength, then we get the two type of the spectra. One is the continuous spectra and other one is the characteristic spectra. Now one by one discuss. First one is the continuous spectra. Now in continuous spectra, or we can say that it consists of radiations of all possible wavelengths within a certain range. The intensity versus wavelength curve for different values of accelerating voltage is shown in this following figure. Means this plot is of intensity versus the wavelength. Now if we see this figure, then it is observed that intensity of the X-ray radiation increases with accelerating voltage. Means what? If we increase the accelerating voltage, then intensity of the X-ray radiation is also increases. Okay. The total intensity of continuous X-ray radiation for a given target is proportional to V square. So the minimum wavelength we can indicate by lambda minimum is independent of the nature of the target material and is directly related to the accelerating potential V. As we can write the equation like this, VE is equal to H mu max, which is equal to HC divided by lambda minimum. Here mu indicates the maximum frequency. H is nothing but the Planck's constant. Okay. Now we know that the relation between the velocity, frequency and wavelength. So according to that equation, instead of mu, we taken C by lambda minimum. Okay. As the target atom is of large atomic weight, the positive charge of the nucleus is surrounded by negative charge electron shown in following figure. That is, here what we get, or we can say that the target atom having large atomic weight, due to this large atomic weight, the positive charge of the nucleus is surrounded by the negative charge electron. Now here we see this diagram. Now in this diagram, here a fast moving electron is passing near to the target atom. It produces the strong repulsive Coulomb force and suddenly slow down and also suffers deflection in path. Means here high velocity electron when passing near to the nucleus, or we can say that near to the target atom, it produces the strong repulsive force, and due to this repulsive force they suddenly slowed down and also suffers deflection in their path. So during this process the electron emits radiation and having energy will be h mu. So due to the different losses in velocity of incident electron, radiation of all possible wavelengths are emitted, and which gives continuous spectrum of X-ray. Okay. After that, now here we have to calculate the wavelength of the emitted X-ray photon. Let us consider an electron whose charge is E accelerated by a potential V. Therefore, the electron gain energy EV, which must be equal to kinetic energy. So here we can write the equation 1 half mv square is equal to E into V. And from this equation we can write the equation V is equal to root of 2 EV divided by m. Here V is the velocity of the striking electron or of mass m. If the entire energy of the electron is converted into the energy of the X-ray, then we can write the equation 1 half mv square is equal to EV, which is equal to h mu. And therefore we can write equation EV is equal to h mu. And from this equation we can write the equation mu is equal to EV divided by h. Now here mu is the, this mu indicates the maximum value of the frequency of X-ray photon. So we know that the relation between the velocity, frequency and wavelength, from this equation we can write the equation lambda minimum is equal to C divided by mu max, and therefore we can write lambda minimum is equal to HC divided by EV. HC divided by E into V. Okay. From this equation. So now second type of the X-ray spectra is characteristic X-ray spectra, or another name of this characteristic X-ray spectra is, we can say, line spectra. Now here in this spectra, or this spectra consists of few peaks superimposed on the continuous spectrum. Now if you see the figure, then it is observed that this is the continuous spectra, and on that continuous spectra there is a few peaks which is superimposed, and hence it is known as a characteristic spectrum. Okay. Now the number of peaks and their corresponding wavelengths are the characteristic of the material used as a target, and these peaks generally occurs in groups and named as a K peaks and L peaks. Now sometimes what happen, the incident high velocity electrons penetrates through the outer shell of the target atom and strike with an electron in the inner shell as shown in this figure. Now if we see these figures, then it is observed that, or from figure A we can say that the high velocity incident electron knock out one electron from K shell shows K shell vacancy is filled up by L shell electron. Means what happen, if you see this figure, then it is observed that high velocity incident electron, so this is the incident electron having high velocity, and that electrons is knock out like this. If this electron is knock out, then that electron create the vacancy, and that vacancy can be filled up by the electron from the other shell, that is L shell electron, or L shell electron filled that vacancy. Now when the L shell electron is come in the K shell orbit, then in L shell orbit that electron produce the vacancy. Again that vacancy can be filled up by the third shell of the orbit, that is M shell. Like this process is going on, and that is nothing but the characteristic, or we can say that line spectra. Now next point we'll discuss about the introduction of the Maxwell equation. Now here we can see that when the charges are in motion, the electric and magnetic fields are associated with them. When charges are in motion, then electric and magnetic fields are associated with them, which will change in both the space and time. Thus, the electric and magnetic fields are interrelated with each other. This phenomenon is known as electromagnetism, and which are mathematically explained by the Maxwell equation. So we can write the Maxwell equation in different, or we can say that differential form. Now these are the four Maxwell equation which is in a differential form. So first equation is nothing but the del into d bar which is equal to rho, called as a Gauss law. Second one is the del into b bar which is equal to zero. Third one is the del cross a bar which is equal to minus dou b bar divided by dou t, and that is nothing but the Faraday's law. And last equation, Maxwell equation, is del cross H bar is equal to J bar plus dou D bar divided by dou T, and that is nothing but the Ampere's circuital law. Okay, so these are the Maxwell's four equations, or we can say that these are the four Maxwell's equation. Now electromagnetic wave in free space. Now here The Maxwell, we know that the Maxwell equation for free space, which is given by del dot E bar is equal to 0, give equation number 1. Del dot B bar is equal to 0, give equation number 2. Third Maxwell equation, del cross E bar is equal to minus dou B bar upon dou T, give equation number 3. And last equation is del cross B bar is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 into dou E bar upon dou T, give equation number 4. Now next one, taking curl of equation 3 we get. Now this is the equation 3, and take the curl of this equation 3, we get del cross E bar. This is the equation number 3, and we are taking the curl of this equation 3 like this. Del cross E bar is equal to del cross minus dou B bar upon dou T. Now right side is written like this, minus dou by dou T del cross B bar. Okay, after that, now we know that the value of, now here we know that the value of del cross B bar, which is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T bar. Here we just put the value of del cross B bar. We get the equation del cross E bar is equal to minus dou upon dou T in bracket mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T. Now taking dot product of above equation. Now this is the equation. Now we take the dot product of this equation. We get, see like this, del dot E bar, okay, minus del dot del into E bar, and which is equal to right side written is as it is, that is minus dou by dou T mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T. Now next one is del dot del into E bar minus del square into E bar is equal to right side as it is. As del dot E bar is equal to 0, then we get, if this term is del dot E bar is equal to 0, then equation becomes minus del square E bar is equal to minus dou by dou T upon mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T. Or we can write this equation like this, del square E bar is equal to dou by dou T minus minus get cancelled, and the equation becomes del square E bar, which is equal to dou by dou T of mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T. Now here just mu 0 epsilon 0 taken outside, and equation write like this, del square E bar is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square E bar divided by dou T square. Okay, now this right side term taken into the left side, so equation becomes del square E bar minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square E bar divided by dou T square, which is equal to 0. Put mu 0 epsilon 0 is equal to 1 upon V square. We get, now here we put, instead of this mu 0 epsilon 0, we put 1 upon V square. So equation becomes del square E bar minus 1 upon V square dou square E bar divided by dou T square is equal to 0. Give equation number 5. Now this is the wave equation for electric field E bar. Now similarly, taking the curl of equation 4. Now we know that equation 4, Ampere's circulated law, last one is the. Now taking the curl of this equation 4, so after taking the curl, we get the equation del cross B bar is equal to del cross mu 0 epsilon 0 dou E bar upon dou T. Okay, now taking dot product, now take the dot product of this equation, we get del dot B bar minus del square इंटू बी बार विच इज इक्वल टू म्यूजर म्यू जीरो इप्सलॉन जीरो डो बाई डो टी इन ब्रैकेट वी कैन राइट डेल क्रॉस ई बार ब्रैकेट कंप्लीट. आफ्टर दैट डेल डॉट बी बार माइनस डेल स्क्वेर बी बार विच इज इक्वल टू म्यू जीरो इप्सलॉन जीरो डो बाई डो टी ऑफ माइनस डो बी बार अपॉन डो टी. Instead of this, del cross e bar is equal to what we get. We know that the value of del cross e bar is equal to minus dou b bar upon dou t. So, as again, del dot b bar is equal to 0. Now, if this value, that is del dot b bar is equal to 0, then this equation becomes minus del square b bar is equal to minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square b bar divided by dou t square, dou square b bar divided by dou t square. So minus minus get cancelled. So equation becomes del square b bar is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square b bar divided by dou t square. Del square b bar minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square b bar divided by dou t square is equal to 0. Now again, instead of this mu 0 epsilon 0, we put the value 1 upon v square. So equation becomes del square b bar minus 1 upon v square dou square b upon dou t square is equal to 0 and give equation number 6. And this is the wave equation for magnetic field b bar. So the solution of equation 5 and 6 is given as. Now solution is like this, E bar in bracket R bar comma T bracket complete which is equal to E 0 bar into E raised to I of K bar dot R bar minus omega T. Similarly for magnetic field the equation becomes B bar R bar T is equal to B 0 bar E raised to I of K bar dot R bar minus omega T. And where B0 and E0, now these are B0 and E0 indicates peak value of electric and magnetic field. K bar is nothing but the wave vector which represent the direction of propagation of wave. And omega is nothing but the angular velocity. Omega by C is nothing but the phase velocity which is equal to the speed of light c in free space. So, thank you.